Can you tell me about your maternal grandparents? What were their names and where did they grow up?
My grandmother came from, my father's mother came from Scotland, Brecon, Scotland. She was claimed to be all Scottish, but who knows? And she had a little bit of a Scottish accent. Oh, she put it on. She was fun. She was 4 feet 11 and over 200 pounds, so she was a little chubby lady. But she was pretty when she was young. I saw pictures of her. Very pretty. And my maternal grandma, my mother's mother came from Kiev, Russia. And she was about, I think she was about 30 when she came. She had started school over there. So yeah. She was a sweet lady, very wonderful. She loved me. I was the first granddaughter. So she used to take me every summer for 2 or 3 weeks. And just take me to the beach every day. She worked, she lived in Beverly, Massachusetts. And we would walk to the beach and she would sit with her Jewish friends and talk Yiddish. And I would go down to the beach by myself and just wait in the water. But I have fond memories of her. She was a beautiful lady.
What was her name?
Her real name was Bertha.
Thanks.
I know. Her real last name was Bertha Ruth.
Do you remember your grandfather's?
My grandfather was Joseph Flasher. Well, it wasn't really Flasher, but whatever that name when he came over on the boat. It probably was Flagel, but they don't, they're not, they can't, it's not the prince.
Yeah. What do you remember about him?
He was kind of serious. Probably not a good memory was he was a gambler. And he gave my grandmother, she had 5 little children, and he gave them the money away. So when the children were little, he got a divorce, which was almost unheard of at that time. So I don't know how she managed, but she managed to raise children. She was a wonderful cook and a wonderful cleaner, very organized.
What are your, some of your favorite dishes that you remember that she made?
Some of my favorite
like
ones.
Like the meals that she made?
She used to make chicken soup, bean soup. Ooh. Yeah, she was always a good cook. The house always smelled wonderful when I went in. I always remember the wonderful smells. Because she cooked every day. She liked cooking. So she was a good grandma, a good example.
What do you remember about your Grandpa Sparks' dad, your grandfather?
I forget the cookies that are famous for Scotland, but they're sweet. Mm. I'll think of it in a minute. But she wasn't a good cook. She didn't cook like my other grandma. Mm-hmm. And sometimes her meat was hard to eat. Seemed like it was always tough.
Yeah.
But anyway, they were different people.
Yeah.
But she was definitely a deep cleaner every Saturday. She pulled every piece of furniture out to
What do you remember about?
And every day, I still have her old soul machine. Every day she sews. She likes sewing.
Is that her machine outside?
Yep, that was hers, yeah. So everybody wants to get rid of it, but I don't. Because it's a memory. I remember seeing every day. Because we live in the duplex house together. So every day I have to go in and play Canasta with her and that. I don't even remember how to play Canasta anymore. It's been so many years.
That's true.
But I'm the only one to just see her. I just sit down and play Canasta with her. So, another funny thing is, we had, at that time we had phones. And it was a three-party phone and she was very cross. She loved to listen to the neighbors talk about other people. You would pick up the phone and be silent and listen to the conversation. So the kids today wouldn't even understand.
Yeah.
That's so funny. Just funny.
Yeah. What do you remember about your grandfather?
Our grandfather was a wonderful, quiet man, loving. And at the age of 80, I took him to see Billy Graham in New York Forward. And he said to me, it sounds just like Billy Sunday. So anyway, he did get saved. He made a little prayer room on the corner of the bedrooms. And every day he would go for a couple of hours and read the Bible. One day he told me to read the Bible twice and read the Bible. So that's
what were their names?
Jeannie Bailey McKenzie Spies. Jeannie Bailey McKenzie was my grandmother. And then she met my grandmother, George. Napier Spies.
Did you have an, oh, can you tell me about your siblings? What were their names and birthdays? Tell me a little bit about each of them.
My brother was 2 years older than me. His name was after my father's, James Kenneth Spies. And Kenny was born, I think it was January 24. And I'm now 84. He would have been turning 86 years old. He was a wonderful brother. Always kind of good to Beverly and I. And a gentle guy. Had a really sweet spirit. I think he got saved in his late teens. At the Church of the Open Bible in Burlington. He said they saw some pretty girls walking into church. And he and his buddy were just driving around, so they decided to go in and try to meet the girls. And he thought the pastor was a good pastor. Gave a call, and him and his friend both got saved.
That's so neat.
Yeah.
And what about Auntie Bev? She's young. Can you tell me about her?
She's 2 years younger than me. My birthday's November 12th. So I'm 84. She just turned 82. So Bev was a good sister. We always hang around together. We slept